These are the top 10 veggies to help you fight diabetes. Number one, collard greens. Collard greens have very low GI glycemic index, so they don't spike your glucose. They're high in fiber, and they help slow down your digestion, which improves blood sugar control. They're also great for heart health, which is always a concern with diabetics. Now, all leafy greens are fantastic. They all have low GI glycemic index, as opposed to the more starchy vegetables like white potatoes or pumpkin. But collard greens are some of my favorites. They're very high in calcium, and the calcium is very bioavailable. It's very absorbable. They're also low in oxalates. So even for those people who are worried about kidney stones, collard greens are a good option. And they don't have that bitter taste of kale. So can't go wrong with collard greens. They're like a powerhouse. You can saute them with olive oil and garlic. You can add them to delicious soups and stews. Many options. And speaking of garlic, that is number two on our list. Garlic is absolutely tremendous for health. For example, studies show garlic helps reduce your fasting blood sugars. Also, there's a molecule present in garlic called allicin, and that can help with insulin secretion and insulin sensitivity. Garlic is also great for the heart, and it has a great taste to foods. You can't go wrong with garlic, except for the garlicky breath, I guess. Yeah, just pop a mint. There's a solution for everything. Number three, avocados. Avocado is technically a fruit, but who cares? It's healthy. People often think of it as a vegetable. Who's counting? I guess we are. This is a top 10 list, right? Avocados are packed with great healthy fats. They're a good source of fiber, vitamin K, vitamin C, and potassium, which can help lower your blood pressure as well. And avocados are so versatile. You can add them to salads. You can use them as a spread. You can use them as a dip. You can use them instead of mayo. You can make guacamole with it. Options galore. Number four, Brussels sprouts. Brussels sprouts also have low GI glycemic index, so not a problem for postprandial glucose levels. They're a great source of fiber, and there are many types of fiber. Soluble fiber tends to be better for certain aspects of health, like heart health, and Brussels sprouts are great for soluble fiber. Here's some good news. You can buy them frozen. You don't have to obsess over getting fresh vegetables every day. It's a hassle. These vegetables, like Brussels sprouts, for example, they're flash frozen while fresh. So they pack in all that nutrition. They last longer in your fridge. You don't have to worry about them spoiling. It's a great solution. Number five, artichokes. Artichokes are also great for fiber. Another type of fiber called inulin, not to be confused with insulin. Inulin is a type of fiber. And inulin helps slow down the absorption of glucose in the gut of sugars. And so it helps stabilize your blood sugar. Inulin also feeds your good gut bugs, your microbiome, and helps with insulin sensitivity. Number six, mushrooms. Okay, technically not a vegetable, it's a fungus. Who cares? They're delicious, they're healthy, have at it. They have very low GI, they're a good source of protein, and some mushrooms contain vitamin D if they've been exposed to sunlight, and vitamin D can help with insulin sensitivity. A clinical trial showed that oyster mushrooms can improve blood sugar levels in diabetics. Another trial showed that another mushroom called Agaricus blasii, Gesundheit. This is popular in some Asian cultures, and these mushrooms can improve insulin resistance in diabetic patients as well. Mushrooms are so delicious. I like to add them to everything. Okay, maybe not ice cream, but everything salty. Come on, you know what I mean. I know some people disagree and hate mushrooms because they have that slimy texture. I got news for you. Those people are wrong. Number seven, broccoli. Broccoli is a great source of fiber. It's a great source of antioxidants as well. There's a compound in broccoli called sulforaphane, and it's especially high in broccoli sprouts, and it reduces blood sugar and hemoglobin A1C, glycated hemoglobin. Number eight, tomatoes. Okay, technically also not a vegetable. It's a fruit. Who cares? We like to cheat. Cheating in a good direction, cheating for our health, not against it. Tomatoes are very high in lycopene, which is an antioxidant, a powerful antioxidant that can help you lower cholesterol and blood pressure. Tomatoes are also very versatile. You can eat them raw in salads. They're delicious. You can eat them cooked. You can put them on homemade pizzas, all kinds of options. Interesting tidbit, cooking the tomato actually increases the bioavailability, the absorbability of the lycopene. So either way, they're great. Eat them raw, eat them cooked, however you want them. Bear in mind, we're talking about actual whole tomatoes, not tomato products, very processed that we find in stores. Often those contain a lot of other ingredients, including a lot of added simple sugars. So careful with those, favor the tomatoes instead. Number nine, cauliflower. Cauliflower has a lot of the benefits we've already talked about. has a low GI, good source of fiber, good source of antioxidants, and it's also very versatile. There's a lot of dishes where cauliflower can replace carbier foods. There's cauliflower rice, cauliflower pizza crust, mashed cauliflower instead of potatoes. Or you can roast cauliflower with olive oil and spices. Love it. Get me some of that. And finally, number 10, apple cider vinegar. Okay, also technically not a vegetable. It comes from a vegetable, okay? Several studies have shown apple cider vinegar helps lower fasting blood sugar in diabetics and hemoglobin A1C, glycated hemoglobin. So it can be a great addition to your toolkit to help with blood sugar control. You can have apple cider vinegar before a meal in a spoon, or you can have it added to foods, or you can dress salads with it. Lots of great options. Here's a lot more on reversing diabetes with diet, and here's the best workout, the best exercises for diabetes. Check them out. I'll see you in there. Bye-bye.